Hi, this is Matthew with Advantage Sign Supply with another quick tip. Today I'm going to show you how to create a custom swatch table and be able to print that swatch table as a chart for easy reference for both you as a designer and for end users as customers. First of all, when we need to make a new swatch table, we can either right click on an existing open chart and go to Open Table. We can get to that same menu by going to our View menu under Color, and we have Open a New Table there. We're going to create a new table first, which will just be blank, and then we're going to open up an existing color table, say our Gerber Scientific table for our 220 vinyls. That will show all of the possible 220 vinyls that Gerber has created. We can click and drag that up to our window to see it easier, and maybe even make it a little bit larger. Now, as opposed to having to process through all of this, we can pick just the colors that we use or the colors that we normally keep in stock and click and drag those into our existing color table. Once we've got all the colors that we need from that chart, we can close it out. We can also go get other tables from our View menu under Color, Open Table. Within your Swatch Library menu, you've got colors from 3M, from Avery, Gerber, which we've already opened, as well as a full Pantone library. We can open up our Pantone and select our solid coated library, which is a pretty common color space. And then we'll drag that up and open it. And we'll grab just a few of these as well. Once we're finished creating our swatch table, we can create a chart of that very simply by going to our View menu and create swatch. Once we click on Current Palette, it'll show us a sample of what that's going to look like, and in Design Central we can control the specifics. In this example, we're going to make 1-inch squares of each color. We're going to put 5 inches of space in between them for the color names, and 1.25 inches of vertical space in between each one so that we have some white space in between each color. We're going to do 4 rows across, and then for our table, we're going to use the new table that we have created here. Under our Advanced tab, that allows us to pick just the colors we want to show in this table, as well as pick the type size and type style that our labels will be in. Once we're done with that, we hit our checkbox, and that shows us our setup. Now, this is grouped together, but if you have something like this issue here, where your name overlaps your lettering, you can always grab it and ungroup it. And then grab just the 2 layers there and manually shift them off to the side. Once you have this printed, you'll be able to show it to a customer to have them choose specific colors, or you can use it as a designer to pick the color that you know that your printer prints best. Hope this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.